Hi friends, today let us see how to draw an 8-point DIF FFT flow graph. So we are going to see how to plot an 8-point DIF FFT flow graph, where DIF stands for decimation in frequency. Now whenever we have DIF structures, that time the frequency components will be not in order, whereas the time components will be in order. So let us first draw 8 total lines. So we are going to draw 8 subsample lines for the graph. Third line, fourth line, and so on so forth. You draw 8 parallel lines. So now we are ready with the 8 parallel input-output lines. This side I am going to write x of n, that is a time sequence, and this side I am going to write x of k, which is a frequency domain or Fourier domain sequence. Here in DIF FFT flow graph we write x of 0, x of 1, x of 2, x of 3, x of 4, x of 5, x of 6, and x of 7. So all the numbers or all the input or time domain sequences are provided in sequence or in order, whereas the frequency domain sequences will be out of order. That means it will be x of 0, then x of 4, then x of 2, then x of 6, then x of 1, x of 5, x of 3, and lastly x of 7. So this is not in order, whereas this is in order. So for DIF FFT flow graph, x of k is not in order, whereas x of n is in order. So how the flow graph looks like? The first stage in the flow graph, let us start from x of n side, have bigger crisscrosses. So we will have the first line meeting with the fifth line. So we'll count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it will be meeting with the fifth line. That is the first crisscross. Second line will be meeting the sixth line, and so on and so forth. So we'll be meeting each line in a bigger crisscross. Now x of 4 onwards, again we will draw, but lines will go up. So it will be x of 4 will get connected to x of 1. X of 1 will get connected to x of 5. X of 2 will get connected to x of 6. And x of 3 will get connected to x of 7. So in this way, all the crisscrosses will get connected to each other. And the second line, the second set of line, that is the last 4 lines, will have a multiplier factor of -1. So I will have here as -1, here as -1, -1 and -1. So last 4 lines will have -1, first 4 lines will not have any multipliers. So let us analyze what will be the output sequence at this stage. So when I see the output, I see whenever the two lines meet, we need to add. So whenever x0 meets with x4, I need to add, and the output comes as x0 plus x4. Next is x1 plus x5. Next is x2 plus x6. Next is x3 plus x7. So plus x7. Here again we will have x0, but now x4 is coming with a minus sign. So it will be minus x4. Then we have x1 minus x5. Then we have x2 minus x6. And so on, x3 minus x of 7. So these are the output of the first stage. After getting the output of the first stage, before entering the second stage, we need to multiply the sequence on last four lines with the following multipliers. The first multiplier is w8 raised to 0. Second multiplier is w8 raised to 1. Next multiplier is w8 raised to 2. And final multiplier is w8 raised to 3. So now I have multiplied the four samples with four multipliers. With this multiplier, just to recall, the values of these multipliers will be from the circle, the DFT circle. So we have a unit circle which is now divided into 8 equal parts. So the value over here is 1, which is w8 raised to 0. Then the value over here is w8 raised to 1, which is equal to 0.707 minus j.707. Then here we have w8 raised to 2, which is minus j. Here we have w8 raised to 6, which is equal to j. Here we have w8 raised to 4, which is equal to minus 1, and so on and so forth. So from this circle, I can easily get what is w8 raised to 0, w8 raised to 1, w8 raised to 2, and w8 raised to 3, which will be 0.707 minus 0.707. Okay. Now, after this, let us enter into the next stage. In the second stage, the crisscross is now shortening. So first we have bigger crisscross. Now the crisscrosses will go on becoming smaller and smaller. So now I will have crisscross in upper four lines and lower four lines alone. So the upper four lines goes as 1, the first line will meet the third line, the second line will meet the fourth line. Here in the reverse manner, it will go like this. Similar way. Okay, then second two lines will have minus 1. These last two lines will have minus 1. And then the input that will come for this will be x of 0 to x of 1. Let us write as x 1 dash. Let give this name whole as x 2 dash. This as x 3 dash, x 4 dash, and so forth. So I'll write here input as x1 dash, then here I have x2 dash, then we have x3 dash, x4 dash. Now x5 dash, I'll write here x5 dash, but x5 dash will be now x0 minus x4 multiplied by w8 raised to 0. Now from the circle, w8 raised to 0 is 1. So I will have 1 multiplied by this number. Okay, so now we will get x6 dash as multiplying x1 minus x5 with w8 raised to 1, which is nothing but 0.707 minus j.707. And then so on and so forth, if I go, I will get these samples. Now, let us see what will be the output of the second stage. The output of the second stage will be x1 dash plus x3 dash. Next will be x2 dash plus x4 dash. Here it will be x1 dash minus x3 dash, and so on and so forth. It will go x2 dash minus x4 dash. Here it will be x5 dash minus x6 dash, and x7 dash minus here it will be plus x7 plus x6 dash. Here it will be x5 dash minus x7 dash, and here it will be x6 dash minus x8 dash. Now you got again a new samples at the output. Now what we will be doing is we'll be doing the third stage. The third and the last stage contains the smallest crisscrosses of this flow graph. So it will be between two lines. And every second line will now have a multiplier. Now, before going from second stage to third stage, we have again multipliers in between. That multipliers are given as always on the last two lines. The multiplier is on these two lines, which is W8 raised to 0 and W8 raised to 1. Here also W8 raised to 0 and W8 raised to 2. It's not 1, it's 2. W8 raised to 0, W8 raised to 2, W8 raised to 0, W8 raised to 2. And finally, you will get x0, x4, x2, x6, and so on and so forth. So this is the basic flow diagram of a DIF FFT flow graph. So it contains three stages: stage 1, stage 2, stage 3. Stage 1 has longest crisscrosses, which is in between 8 lines. Stage 2 has a shorter wave crisscrosses between 4 lines, and lastly the crisscrosses are between 2 lines, the shortest crisscrosses on the flow graph. X of n is in order, x of k is not in order, or we call this order as bit reversed order. We call this order as bit reversed order. So instead of saying not in order, I will call it as bit reversed order. That is the flow graph of DIF FFT flow graph. Thank you.